For our map, we'll now add some context around the history of the World Cup by plotting a circle on the map for each year of the World Cup, where its radius represents the attendance for that year. One thing to note is that I abstracted our rollup aggregation function into a function defined above as aggyear for more reusability and clarity. The process of overlaying circles on our map is identical to what we did when we created a scatter plot. The only difference in this case is that we're using our nested aggregation of our data. And if you remember internally, our aggregation used a projection. In our scatter plot, we used a scale to convert from our data domain to our pixel range. But since we're dealing with geographic coordinates, we use a projection to convert from a longitude and latitude domain to pixel values, which we've already computed in center X and center Y. And just as in most of the charts we've made in D3, we first append a group. We're going to be labeling it with class bubble. We select all the circles in that group already, which in this case is empty, bind data to those circles, resulting in empty placeholders, of which we then make an enter selection corresponding to all of the empty placeholders with data bound to them. And for each of those, we append a circle on our map.